What is going on YouTube and Star Wars fans? This is Slade Bolin here, and today I have a very special review for you all. Now, I have been waiting to get this figure in my collection for some time, and now that I finally have her, I think that it will be the best to have an official review on the figure and give you all my viewpoints on how I view this figure. Now today, as you can see, we're going to be reviewing the Star Wars Black Series 6-inch Rey figure, or Island Adventure figure. As you may recall, this is how Rey looks in the Last Jedi movie, as well as the ending of The Force Awakens when she goes to see Luke Skywalker. And I honestly have been waiting for this figure since I did see some people online making their own versions of this figure. Yet I couldn't, so I was like, I might as well just wait, because eventually they're going to have to make this figure for the premiere of The Last Jedi. And they did. Like I said, of course, I picked this figure up on Amazon for $25. Because I did wait until the price went down on her a bit before I bought her. But as you all also can see, I'm doing something new this time. I know how you all are used to seeing me review the figures inside of the packaging and then switching over to the figures outside of the packaging. But I thought to myself, just so I can make it one video, why not just review the box itself and then just move straight into the figure without any jump cuts whatsoever. So I thought I figured I'd go with that first. So first I'll review the box. See if I can scoot right to the back here. Of course, as you can see, it is the say Star Wars the Black Series figures. Or the Black Series per se. And moving down here, you see the figure is called Rey Island Journey. Has a nice portion of Rey right there. Nice reflective, and of course it's by Hasbro. Moving over to the side of the box, you can see that this figure is number 58 in the Black Series line. Which I'm kind of glad that they actually have more getting up into the Black Series line. Of course, you know how I always do it. If you guys want, there's the intro, basically a description of the figure is. If you all want to pause the video to read that, you can. Of course, unless you don't read it, if you read it already. Moving down here, you have all this information, like, you know, who made the figure, who, what the figure has in there, like it says here, the figure has free accessories and all that. The websites where you can go on to buy the figure or look for the figure. On the other side of the box, you also, it says Rey Island Journey again. And I don't know if you can see it, but I just noticed this technically, but if you see it's faded right here, it says Rey. I mean, I actually didn't notice that about the box, but it actually had their names, like Ghost faded into the side under the official name of the figure. But I'm actually happy that they went along with that, because it actually adds more customization to the box wise. Now putting the box back here. Now before I get into the official figure review, I always like to review the accessories first. And this figure does come with quite a bit of accessories. She's probably even wearing one, but I'll get into that later on. Her first accessory here, actually kind of like it. It's like a cloak or whatever. You know, like, I know in some scenes in the movie she actually wore like a cloak over herself. But the fact that they actually went ahead and gave you this cloak is really good, a really good choice for an accessory. As you can see, it's just fabric cloth or a cloak. You can slip it over her whenever you want. She does have a hood. I'm going to get into the hood in a minute, because there is a gripe with that, but it's not a big one. But okay, putting that aside, of course, since she's Rey, she does come with her iconic staff. And actually, this staff has more better paint apps than my last Rey staff, as you may recall from my Rey and Luke Skywalker figure review, if you saw that one. This staff has actually more black paint detail. Of course they did add a flexible strap so you can obviously slip it over her shoulder when you want to, so you can have her either holding the staff or wearing the staff on her back like she does in the movie. Now putting that aside, she does come with a lightsaber. And funny enough, the lightsaber for this one, well, this figure is actually really good. Like, I know you have probably seen numerous videos where I've done reviews with figures that come with the Skywalker lightsaber, but this lightsaber is actually pretty decent. My one gripe is if you can kind of see a tiny bit, it is kind of bent in. As you can see, see if I can bend it back into shape. I don't like bending my lightsabers because I don't want to break the blade plague pagan side. As you can see, the lightsaber, even though it's a little warped from packaging, is actually a very nice detail. You can probably tell that the type of paint they chose to use for this lightsaber is more silver metallic in a way. You can see that nice little gleam it has right there. Nice detailing. That's extreme detailing in a little red button right there. Which I think is good in the little switches there. Nice tap apps of gold paint there and black for the guards and a nice little belt clip D-ring loop that you see in the movie. The fact that they added that D-ring is a really good sign. Because I actually talked about that in previous reviews, how some of the lightsabers I have don't come with the official D-ring loop. As you can see, the blade is a really nice shade of blue. It manages to capture the light relatively well, in a sense. And I figure I like that. I know most of the blades I have are like, you know, faded blue or too blue. Of course, it does take some finessing, but the blade is removable. As you can see, it's basically just a threaded peg. Let's see if I can... if my camera wants to focus. As you can see, it's a threaded peg that obviously fits into the lightsaber hole right here. It comes out, it comes back in. My only gripe with the figure is that it did not come with a way of actually storing the lightsaber on her person, like as in on her waist, like on most of my figures. I'll probably get into that in like a few individual figure. I just wish that was something that Hasbro kind of would have added to the Rey figure, even though you technically don't see her wearing a lightsaber in the movie that much. I'm only holding it. Of course, she does come with her blaster pistol. As you see, it is the blaster pistol that Han Solo gave her in The Force Awakens. But this one is actually different. You all might have noticed on my one Rey figure that the blaster was a little smaller on that figure. But on this one, it's actually a little bit bigger. And it's not as bent or malformed as my other one was, because I know the packaging, this part of the blaster was bent at an angle, so I had to halt and push that back into place, and it still looks a little bent. But it does fit into a holster relatively well, which is a difference from my one figure, because it didn't fit in the holster that well, and it was actually starting to tear her holster, so I kind of got scared of putting it in and out, or taking it back out and putting it back in there several times. I didn't want her holster to end up ripping apart because it's kind of made of a soft plastic in a way. As you can see, it's just a traditional blaster. It has just a touch of silver metallic paint and a touch of black paint on the handle. Nice grooving on the handle. See if I can see some nice little tech designs on the handle, like its little grooves or whatever. Like I said, it's just a common pistol. Now, officially, I'm going to start getting into the figure now, obviously. As you can see, Hasbro, they chose to go with this type of, I don't know what they call it, face scan. Well, basically, they scan the actual actor's face and they use the implement on the figures. Because actually getting into the figure's face first, you can tell that it looks a lot like Daisy Ridley from Star Wars. As you can see, basically it's near uncanny from apart from my other Rey figures I've had. I know I've probably reviewed the Jedi version of her, where the face sculpt basically didn't look nothing like her. With the original Force Awakens figures, they look a little bit wonky in a way. But as this figure, you can actually clearly see that, if my camera will focus, she looks exactly like Daisy Ridley, especially from the front and the sides. I do admit there is some difference, but it's like so little that it's barely not even there. Actually, I can probably do a comparison for you. So here alongside her, I do have my Star Wars The Force Awakens Rey figure. As I recall, I think this was the first figure that I reviewed for my channel. Well, I think it was. But as you can see, the face sculpt for this one, as you can see, it's just horrible, honestly. Like, it looks nothing like Daisy Ridley. It's just like her, first of all, her buns. Also, you can notice it's really good change in her buns here. Like, you see her bun is like, it's a hard type of plastic. It's like, this figure, honestly, I'm sorry, but this figure is kind of ugly to me. Because one, it doesn't look like Daisy Ridley whatsoever. But then you can move on to the figure that I'm reviewing right now. Put her right there. And you can see that not only did they match her face really well to Daisy Ridley, but they also changed how her buns are. Like, I just showed you how her buns were a harder plastic on her, on that figure. The buns are actually a very flexible, soft plastic. I mean, of course, is this one a soft plastic? This one a soft plastic? And then this one is hard plastic. And you can tell a major difference. How I changed the buns. It's similar, it looked really similar, but they're still there. Her, I guess her hair's more softer and crisper than this one's. But I'll see, if I could, I would probably pop the head off of this figure and probably put it on this figure if I really wanted the Jakku Rey figure that looked somewhat authentic. But honestly, it'd just be a waste of time, honestly, because I'd rather prefer this figure, honestly, over there overall. But getting into the articulation for this figure, her arm does go out that far and it goes back in. It does rotate 360 degrees at the shoulder. It does bend at the elbow, and also does 360 degrees at the elbow. You do have a wrist pivot, and that wrist also swivels 360 degrees here. She does have an ab crunch. It's a very, I mean, it's not a bad crunch, but it's not a good one either. It's like in the middle. Of course, this jacket here is kind of hindering the figure's movements, but I'll get to that in a moment. Her legs do go out that far, and they go back in. They go at two, back and forth, out in, and you rotate at the thigh, which is actually a really good rotation for these figures. I know that these figures have some tight rotations in the thigh area, but this figure actually has really good articulation in the thigh area. Her knees are double jointed, and the best part about it is that it has a thick joint. I don't know if you all have probably seen that on some of the Jyn Erso figures. Her knee joint was so thin that if you tried bending it, it would eventually just snap and her whole leg would just fall off. Like I said, I don't know why they chose to make her figure's legs joints that thin. I guess it's because of how small the figure was. But with this figure, they altered to make the joints really thick. So you don't have to worry about breaking these ones. As like I said, her knee is double jointed. It bends that in that far and goes back out. She does have an ankle rocker pivot. Her foot goes up that far, which is actually really technically really far up for a figure's ankle to go up. And it goes back down that far, and of course it does rotate at the ankle 360 degrees. For her head, it does the same traditional Black Series, rotates 360 degrees and goes up that far and goes down relatively far. The only reason why her head doesn't go up that far is, like I said before, the jacket is hindering her movement. But getting into the jacket, As you notice, her jacket's made of this really malleable soft plastic. But if you wanted to, you could take this off. I mean, like I said, it does take some finessing to do to take off her jacket. See if I can do it on camera for you all. Basically, it's more of a like once you get her one arm through that, it's easy. Just take the rest off. Make sure she's taking her jacket off. Of course, this is what she looks like without her jacket. No, I'll actually review the jacket. You know, it's just because of a figure review. Like I said before, if you wanted to, you can also count this jacket as an additional accessory to the figure, as it is removable. And you can choose to have it on her if you want or not. Funny enough, I actually prefer her without the jacket because, one, she has more range of movement in a sense, and two, because I just prefer figures like this without jackets because you can actually tell she has more depth to her. Like, you know, his jacket, as you can see, nice detailing in the jacket, by the way. And if you go actually move in a little closer, let's see. As you can see by that, there's actually little patterns in the jacket, like, you know, little grooves in the jacket. I figured that was a really good for Hasbro to do, because if they could have just had this all just plain silver plastic with these little lines here and the course the shoulder blades, but they actually went the extra mile and they add this like texture to the jacket. It's like a wave texture almost. I don't know if that's how it looks in the film, but honestly, it just gives you the sense like this is actually fabric that she's wearing, apart from the other jackets, like my Finn jacket, for example, which mainly just looks like it's plastic, no designs or whatever in there. But I figured I'm glad they did that. And of course, as I mentioned before, without the jacket, she does have a little bit more range of movement. Like I said, she's not hindered by the jacket. She does bend back that far, and then she bends in that far. As you can see, it's pretty much the same as before. I also forgot one part of articulation. Her waist does rotate 360 degrees also. And then it goes out and in like that. But with her head, without the jacket on, her head goes up really well. Like, you can see that, of course, this hair is fat, soft plastic. It bends with her head, so she can look up that far up, which I gotta say is, that's amazing that this figure can look up that high without the jacket, because I just showed you before with her jacket on, her neck was kind of hindered because of her collar here. But without the jacket, her head can go up that far, which I said is really good. Like, she has a more detailed head, and it also does that. I mean, it does kind of like she has a long neck, but that's just because that you weren't made to take, you weren't supposed to really take this jacket off. And I guess the collar, they wanted the collar to be able to not be like right on her jawline. She wanted the collar to rest around her neck here, but I'd rather have it without the jacket. As you can see, her arms, they pretty much go up the same height as the jacket, but it's like a smidge higher just because of the the little end of her arm sleeve right here. Like I said, it does look better. I mean, the only downside about her jacket is that it kind of looks like her shoulders are a little bit small, as in a narrow and like lean, but that's mainly because you're just supposed to have it with the jacket on. But like I said, if you want to have her, you know, like she's training or something, like in the film, like how she was training on the rocks with her saber, she didn't have the jacket on, she had just this tank top-esque shirt on. Shows a nice detailing of her, you know, of her, not cleavage, but you know, the opening here for her shirt. The back is just plain, but actually on the back, they actually did some more detail. Like on the back, they didn't have to do this, but they actually added small wrinkles to her shirt. I think that that's a really good thing that they did, because they didn't have to do that. Because they could have just had this just smooth plastic, like just straight smooth plastic, but they actually went the extra mile and added like little tiny wrinkles into her shirt, which I think is a really good thing that they did for this figure. Also, you can see there's more detailing in her belt here, and her holster, which I gotta say, the holster is perfect for holding the blaster, because I just, like I mentioned earlier, how the blaster for my other Rey figure, the Jedi version of her, the holster was made out of this really soft plastic, and the moment you stuck the blaster in, it actually started to tear right here. But with this one, her blaster just goes right in, and it stays in. So like if you turn it upside down, it does not come out like the other one did. And if you want to take a blaster out, what you do is you actually push it up. Like I said, it's just such a seamless motion. Like you pull it up, you pull it back in, and it does not come out. But I actually kind of like that they did that. Like I said, this figure is probably one of my favorite out of the Flag Series line, just for the fact that of how detailed it looks and how close it looks to the actual actress herself. But honestly, if I'm gonna have to rate this figure, I would probably rate it a 10 out of 10, just for those facts included. But yeah, like I said, I do like collecting these figures a lot. Like I said, I am a collector, and I like to collect these figures to review to you all, show you what I don't like about the figure and what I like about the figure. Any flaws that Hasbro might have added to the figures that you all might not have known about. I know some people, they just buy these to collect them, or they buy them to give them to their kids. Me, I just buy them just because I'm a collector. I have a ton of these figures lying on my shelves. I just collect, and I also make sure they're well maintained as well. Like I'll clean off any dust that they might have, or cobwebs or whatever, or make sure their cloaks remains normal, like they're not frayed or anything over time. But yeah, that was my Star Wars The Black Series Rey Island Journey figure. Now of course, if you like this video, you can leave a like below and subscribe. Of course, like I say in all my videos, you don't have to. But if you just like the video, you know, just want to help a guy out, you can. We'll probably review some more figures in the future. I don't know which ones I'll review. Most likely, I'll probably just review all the new figures I have, and then maybe some more of my customization figures. Maybe I'll review some figures that you all haven't seen yet. But yeah, that was the review, and have a nice day.